stuff.
Is it starting to angle out? Yeah, yep. Well, it could be one of our best then if it's starting to angle up.
It is angling away from the boat. Here it comes.
Well, Sonia, Matty, just don't give up, mate, you know? Just start getting your head down a little bit. It's a good lesson for you.
Welcome to UltimateFishing.tv. I'm Matt Watson, and I'm about to introduce another feature-length episode for you to watch right here for free. And this one is part one of two, and it's quite a special episode, or a couple of episodes, because I've got a couple of elite athletes out fishing with me, fierce rivals, America's Cup sailors, Jimmy Spithill and Dean Barker. And this is following on from the America's Cup, where Team USA came from behind, 8-1 down, to beat Team New Zealand. The whole country was devastated, but there was a lot of controversy because it seemed that the Americans were making up the rules. Well, this is going to be the competition that is going to end it all of the disputes. It is the ultimate cup. They happen to be fishing with me in an incredibly good time of the year here in my home patch in the Bay of Islands in New Zealand. There's a whole load of deep sea fish.
Wow, what a fish. That's the biggest fish I've ever caught in my life.
As well as some amazing inshore fishing.
Here we go, that's a nice one.
Nice work. And we get in amongst some of the best kingfishing action I've experienced. We figure that four times more people go fishing than go sailing, so this is four times more important than the America's Cup. It is the ultimate cup, and yours truly was setting the rules. It was the sporting event that stopped our nation, and it stirred up Kiwi pride and passion like never before. It was perhaps the most dramatic sporting event in history.
No, Team New Zealand are in trouble here. Team New Zealand, can they save it? That was almost a disaster for Team New Zealand. The big roll tack, they nearly come unstuck.
The small but proud sailing nation of New Zealand are taking on the America's Cup holders. Oracle Team USA, with their hometown advantage and their huge budget. And yep, we almost pulled it off. Dean Barker and those courageous Team New Zealand sailors almost got it. But 8-1 down, Jimmy Spithill sailed his team to a remarkable comeback victory.
Oracle Team USA win the 34th America's Cup.
Despite this newfound overnight speed advantage, but we won't get into that. And we were gutted, devastated the nation. But now we have a chance to square the ledger, to right the wrongs. It's Barker versus Spithill in a head-to-head fishing challenge to take ultimate glory. The winner restoring glory to the nation, the loser to be sent packing back to America.
Or Aussie, or where do you?
I might got a spot here in New Zealand, but mate, what's all this packing? Sending me packing?
Don't worry about that. That's just the intro. I'll just carry on with the intro. So the rules are, guys, it's a series of fish challenges we're going to put you through. You and Dean are going through the same challenges. The biggest fish is a win. First to nine wins takes it out, just like the America's Cup, as you've been told and you've been shown all the rules. I'll show you the rules later.
Okay.
But you are permitted to have a grinder or winder with you. Aaron, you've brought along, you've elected to have, and you've won the toss, so you're first up and taking advantage of the weather. What do you want to start with?
Yeah, beauty, mate. I'll just probably take it easy at the start and then, put a bit of effort in at the end. You know, I sort of prefer that. I've got my grinder and he's under 56 years of age. You know, that's how we like to do it. So, yeah, it should be a bit of fun.
Yeah, I hope that little dig wasn't lost on the viewers there.
I'll tell you what, you wouldn't want to be a fish today. Big trouble.
Rightio, you get that one underway, Jimmy, and I will get a rig sorted out that I've got on here for a big snapper or a massive kingy. The old secret snapper spot and the old secret snapper rig. Because the water's murky, a fish will be relying on scent more than anything, and hopefully a big old snapper or kingy's going to come along and nail that.
mate. That's what a bait looks like, son.
Right, okay. Get some weapons down for you fellas.
Well, we're waiting for one of these big baits to smoke off.
Your weapon there.
Yeah, nice. Where's the button? You guys have that? Oh, that's right.
Now I'm here, of course, to keep my eyes on both Jimmy and Dean to make sure that they abide by the strict set of rules, but I'm also here to assist the fellas, impartially, of course. So I'll just show you how we'll bait these up. Take said hook and go through just one end and pull it right through all the way, and then through and out again. And what that does is it makes the hook lay straight, little sinker on top, and that'll float down in the current, like say, snapper comes along or kahawai, and you should hook one.
Got it.
Well, you might as well grab this one, Aaron.
Righto, let's get into it, eh? Time to score some points.
See if we can get some runs on the board. Oh yeah, you got him.
Oh,
he's got him.
Nice. Oh, how's that?
The grinder's underway, and like a true grinder, he's just winching it in. Not a lot of finesse there. And what is it? That's kahawai.
Mate, we're on the board.
That's a kahawai.
Throw it back in, mate. Hardly worth putting on the camera.
That's brilliant. The comp's measurement based, so any scoring fish we'll measure. And the official score for that one is 24 centimetres for kahawai so far. Did you say something about a slow start, didn't you, Jimmy?
It's not how you start, Matty, it's how you finish, buddy. This will probably be bigger than yours, Aaron. Not like you haven't heard that before.
Oh, snapper.
What do you reckon, that's a feed in Sydney.
Well, he's one of the qualifying species, so we will put him on the measure map. That's 25 centimetres. You want to claim those as points, or?
Oh, mate, points on the board, eh?
Throw them away. A legal snapper in New Zealand's actually at the moment is 27 centimetres. And by claiming it, you've just forfeited, you know, that's actually illegal. And I'll check the rules, but I think that might be minus 2 points.
Oh. Not again.
There are rules.
Can't get away from
this. We'll just have a look here. Page 19, subsection 17, clause 15.1. Any claimed snapper or any fish of any species not of the recommended legal size shall be docked 2 points. No, I'm not. Hey, it's in here, mate. You've seen the rules.
Well, maybe I haven't.
That doesn't matter. You can read them later. Look, it's a piece of cake. Look, it's just a couple of minor details.
After the Supreme Court. I'm appealing.
Not the ideal start, Jimmy, minus two, but hey.
Yeah, oh well.
Trying to claim an undersized snapper has cost Jimmy 2 points in the stray line snapper section. This now gives Dean the opportunity to take out the first leg. But to do so, he still has to catch a legal snapper using the standard stray lining technique.
The belly trail's cranking good now. Right, okay. Now, Dean, your turn. You happy to start with snapper?
Yeah, keen to get into a bit of snapper fishing.
Yep.
I'm going for it.
Okay, so technically I shouldn't tell you what you've got to beat. You've just got to claim a snapper that you're happy with before we move on to our other species. And I see you've gone for quite a big hook there. So you're fairly optimistic going for the big stuff?
Just sort of try and get a legal snapper would be a good start.
It would be a very good start. Okay, well, I'll let you flick that out and I'll introduce over here our grinder, Wooly. See, we've brought in a ringing, the big guns. Wooly from Hunting and Fishing New Zealand. And Wooly, what are you going for over here?
I've done the same as Dean. I've got a big piece of skipjack tuna, fresh. See where here we go.
Of course, it's basically all eating fish that we're after. And when you've got a burley trail set up and the water's salty, you can really catch some fish and it could be an opportunity to rack up some points, fellas, so good luck. Oh, look, there's snapper in our burley trail. Look at that, right there, snapper. That's what that burley will do. It just sucks them right up to the surface like that. Well, you have seen them on the surface here before like that, but that is pretty neat every time you see it. Oh, you hit him. Get him moving. That's a real good one, mate. Tighten up.
Yes.
Get him moving. You still got him?
Yep.
Oh yes, you're safe now. You're in the safe zone. You got him away from the... I shouldn't say that. No. Yeah, we don't like to can our chickens. You want to get that net, Wooly? I'll carry on rigging up a live bait. Here we go. Oh, it's a nice snapper.
Beautiful. That's a measurer. First one of the day.
Of course, it's the angler's call is what happens to the fish when they catch it. You know, so if you want to take them for a feed, it'd be a nice eating sort of size fish if you wanted to.
It's always good to throw the first one back, isn't it?
I'm hoping you were going to say that.
43 centimetres. Put them back.
All right. Swim well.
Swim off all right?
Yeah.
No, he's, beautiful. Well done.
No, it was good.
Oh, yep. Something on the live bait, I think. Hopefully it hasn't. Something's snapped right up on the surface. This is your live bait, Monte. Here, grab this one. Grab this one. It's way better because it's got a fish on it. Could be a big snapper that's come right up to the surface. See that live bait? That was right up on the surface. Although I do happen to know that snapper do come right up on the surface here. It is too. It is too right on the surface. Where's our net? Keep him in the water. On the lithey. Under a balloon. There you go. Yes. Straight off the bat, Dino, you have gone and nailed a nice burly trail snapper. Nice one, mate. Okay, that's a good start. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is your other rod, bro. This is a good fish too, mate. That was smoking. Here, mate, come grab your rod. I'll deal with that other fish. There's a bigger one here. Oh, the man's on fire. I just can't recall whether, I just really don't think that Jimmy started quite so well. I'm gonna quickly measure this. And are you happy for this one to go back, Dean? Okay, beauty. See, you put them back and you get good mojo. Okay, that one is 60 centimetres. 60 centimetres, that one. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Guide him over. Gently. Get it under him. Whoa! Straight line snapper. Hey. Oh, look at it. Oh, sweet. I mean, that rod was so skillfully placed in the rod holder there. Well, I think a measure and a photo, that's a well photo-worthy fish. Oh, look at that big old tail. Stray-lined.
That is a nice fish, eh? It's a good healthy one.
Yeah.
But that's 64.
Lift him up and I'll take the rag off. Just to get that pick. Oh, look at those colours, man. Just snap it like that, never gets old. Oh, yes. And when you're ready, let him rip. Oh no, oh, thought he wasn't going to swim off, but he's powered away.
Good.
Nice teamwork, boys. That's what we like to see, well-oiled machine. Well, I'm going to get this out of the way because the snapper look like they're biting, and we'll just get some more bait to pump back in that burly trail. Yep. You got him. You just love that, eh? Zzz, click. Boom. Love it. I don't know if this one will need a net, Wooly. You might just be able to lift this one in. Yes!
What's the technique when they've actually swallowed the hook pretty well?
Well,
without doing too much damage to the...
Again, well, what we'll do is we'll decide, you know, because we haven't taken any fish yet,
yeah,
and this is a good size.
Yeah, well, it's a good cook.
Yeah,
fish,
exactly. Yeah. So, I mean, there is a chance that we could carefully get that hook out, but he's more likely to die, you see? So that's how we like to select our fish. If it doesn't, if we don't think they're going to make it, well, then they're the perfect ones to eat.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Wooly.
Go, Wooly.
Oh, no, that was a beauty. Hey. There we go. I'm trying to do a piece to camera in the back of shot. Wooly's getting smoked by Big Snapper. So I've just ickied this guy to kill him, and he'll go on ice. And once again, it's really just about selective fishing. So
yeah, well, it's always hard when they've swallowed it like that, isn't it?
That's right. So they might as well be the ones that you take home. Oh, hello. Oh, I can't do any. I'm trying to make some TV here, Dean. You got to stop hooking fish, mate. You got to stop hooking fish. Obviously, Dean's going great guns on snapper. In fact, Team Barker seems to be doing particularly well this morning, but it's all about eating fish and different varieties of eating fish. So our grinder, Wooly over here, is taking the initiative and he's dropped right down. Obviously these are really tiny baits for these big snapper that are around. But when you've got burley out, there's other species like your trevellies, even some of your large mackerel like your kohoru, porai, and even tariki. So the ledger rig is just such an all-round rig, and he's going to drop that and see if we can generate some other eating fish.
Yep.
Could be something a little bit different. Okay, I'm going to have to get the net because we're not big, strong hooks. Hopefully a trevally. Trevally is what you boys want. Trevally is it? Oh yes, it's a trevally. Leave them in the water. They're soft mouths. Yes, trevally. That's another species. Another great eating. Oh, I love it when you put a plan together.
Nice work.
What a team. You guys are slick. And that's going to be legal. So, pretty much trevally when they come on board, man. You've got to ice those guys. And that's sashimi. That is your inshore. You know, offshore you've got your yellowfin tuna and your bluefin tuna for sashimi, inshore trevally. There's a lot better eating fish going around than just snapper, and it'll take the pressure off snapper, because over 55% of all recreational fish that are caught in New Zealand, right from the top of New Zealand to the bottom, are snapper. And you know, we love them, so try eating some other fish, the kahawai, the tarakihi, your trevallies, also great eating fish, so give them a go.
It's 32 centimetres.
32. Nice work, Wally. Looks like your rig did the trick there, mate.
Didn't have to rebait, we'll go again. Yep.
Another trevally by the looks of that rod tip. That's a telltale with the trevally. You see the rod tip going like that? That normally is an indicator that it's the old mate, the trevally.
Double header.
Oh, nice. Oh no, trevally and a little snapper. Oh. Swing those in, they're not going anywhere. That burley, eh? See? Burley. Oh, yes. Get him moving. Get him moving.
This is a shot that I want to get.
Doesn't feel quite so impressive now, but.
Oh, yeah, so nothing wrong with that one.
Another fresh bit of bait, beautiful snapper.
And he's hooked in the corner of the mouth, so there you go, we were talking about selective fishing before. He's a mouth hooked one, so he's a good candidate to go back. Stunning fish. Well done, Dino, you're making it look easy, mate.
A nice fish.
Tis indeed. Trevally on there, I'd say. Looking at the rod tip. Doing the trevally shuffle. There you go. I think that might be a slight improvement. Look at the colours on that one. Geez, they're a neat fish. We'll get a measure on him. 34. Yeah, I'll get this guy chilled down. Change of rig. See, we've been here all morning, not seen a trevally. Change your rig, change your technique. Obviously a pretty slick team here. Know their stuff.
Dean's off to a great start, scoring a point with the biggest strayline snapper. And Team Barker has also registered a trevally.
Yes, trevally, that's another species.
So now the heat's on Jimmy to improve on his minus 2 points. He's currently holding the biggest kahawai, but it's a tiny fish of just 24 centimetres. So he'll have to improve on that, or catch a trevally bigger than 34 centimetres if he's got any real chance of scoring in the strayline section of the Ultimate Cup.
Oh, look at that. He's gone.
I'm on again, Ace. What about you? Have you got a snapper yet?
Yeah, no, I just...
Patience, mate.
Oh, there he goes.
We lost another two, Ace.
He's outdone himself.
Minus four.
Well, you didn't claim it. So long as you don't claim it, okay, it's not legal. It's a bit of risk to claim it.
Oh, we're on it.
Yeah, it's a bit better one, isn't it?
A little bit better.
Don't lose any more points, whatever you do. Mate, do you want the gaff?
Hey, you reckon we can make any changes to the boat?
There you going over there, Ace? You got a snapper yet? Or? Not yet.
There's no eye in
teeth. There's no eye in teeth. How's that go, Jimmy? Some phrase I used to during the cup, didn't
I? I don't know what you're talking about, to be honest.
Oh, look at that. He's on. There you go. Good on you, boy.
Yeah, someone's got to take control, Ace, you know.
It could be the live bait that catches the winning fish, though.
Oh, I'm probably not going to measure it up, to be honest.
There you go, just... There's your shot. No, there's your shot. Get in there.
Look at that, Dave, over there, buddy. Is that a while?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Fishing with Matt Watson, eh?
Hey, you can lead a horse to water.
Well, mate, just the sort of start you like.
We've got them right where we want them, boy.
Got them right where we want them.
Just a little bit longer.
Larry wants an update shortly, and I don't know what to say.
Oh, well, fellas, I did have a plan. I had a real set plan. I was hoping it was going to come off here, but fishing's fishing. You know, I'm sure the fish are here, that it's not biting, so...
Yeah, mix it up, eh? Try something different.
Okay. Don't worry, mate, you're in good hands.
Thanks, mate, yeah.
I'll look after you.
Good to have a plan, though, isn't it?
Yeah, but it is good to have a plan.
What was it, by the way?
It was to hook a big shark.
Good copy.
Now to put a cork back in a champagne bottle? Just ask anyone on Team New Zealand.
Oh. Oh, right. Okay, yeah, now I just changed my mind for our next spot.
Team Spithill has not had much success in the stray line section, so Jimmy has made the call to change tactics and head out and try some deeper water to improve on his disastrous start of -2 points. Meanwhile, Dean is playing a smart game, changing up his tactics and looking to extend his lead by using a different technique.
Righto, guys, you cleaned up on the bait fishing. Lure fishing time. Dean, I see you've set yourself up here with a Lacanus, which would have been my choice. You were saying a moment earlier, Dean, that you like to fish your Lacanus with some Trigger X Ultra Bite Pheromone Gel. And I agree, actually. I mean, these are a metal lure. They're a crazy looking little lure. Snappers seem to love them, but they seem to love them just that little bit more when you use the old Trigger X Gel. It's got that extra attractive quality. And, look what I've got. The only one in the country. It's gonna be the latest thing. It's what you're gonna see. It's gonna be going off this summer, micro jigging. And this is the Colt Sniper flat fall jig. It's only 35 grams, and it's coming out of the Shimano stable. And I mean, they've introduced these things, these Raikus, the bottom ship lure, and the now famous Lacanus jig that Dean's using. So this is the latest that they've come up with. It's got the little Japanese writing on there that means those crafty little Japanese fellas have made them and they know how to make some lures. Oh, hi! Nice and smooth with them, mate. What you got? What you got? It'd be nice if it was a gurnard, mate. I would be pumped to see a gurnard. Oh, you're kidding me! You're kidding me! It's a gurnard! It's a gurnard! Bring it on over! Yeah.
Yes! Anything to beat Spithill.
We needed another species. And what have we got? And we're talking about catching eating species and they don't get much more quality than a gurnard, mate. I hardly ever catch them, honestly. Obviously, you're quite experienced at catching them.
Yeah, well, that's what I was targeting.
Just so you know, if you were thinking of releasing it, any gurnard that comes on this boat goes in the bin.
Well, get it away from the side of the boat. Yeah,
we've got to get a measure on it, eh? We've got to get a measure on it. Oh, well, it's got to be legal too, so that's what we've got to check. I think it is.
What is the size of a gurnard?
25 centimetres.
I swear.
Well, you see, Wooly, he's from Napier, where this is one of your staple catches down there. And yeah, it's an interesting thing. I haven't caught one for so long. Can you hear that? Hear that? Making that noise? I could translate, but it's a G-rated show, and he's saying some nasty things about Dean.
Jimmy.
Yeah. Nah, that's definitely not a Spithill fish. The head's way too small. 36 centimetres. And just before we put him in the bin, these stunning wings, you know, they're great to take kids out to catch gurnard because they just look beautiful. They taste fantastic. This is the craziest looking fish. They've got these little legs on them. Look at that real sharp, shovely nose. And they use that to dig in under the sand. Flick up out all the crabs and stuff. They love eating all those crabs and crustaceans. Well done, guys. Good strategy there with the going for the Lacanus. Oh, on this little micro jig. Oh, yes.
Look at this reel go. Oh no! It was the only one in New Zealand and it got smoked.
That was a big snapper, boy.
Oh no, got smoked.
At least you got it on film, eh? Yeah.
It's a pretty little one.
It only needs to be legal.
I would say we're going to be struggling for that.
Going to be struggling? Oh, yeah.
Beautiful, right.
That is a, just hold that up, please, Dean, for the camera. That is a legal size snapper. And, you know, while we might say, oh, well, geez, it's tiny, to a lot of people that don't have access to getting out in boats, there's still some quality eating there. So why don't we put it back and maybe someone else can get it. Maybe in bed it'll grow up and have lots of babies. You using a Lacanus, eh, Dean?
Yep.
Okay, so yeah, a snapper's obviously a species and techniques. Lacanus or metal jig. Lacanus, there you go. And legal size fish. So I really don't think there's probably much point in us continuing on here. Well, I think we've proved the point. We'll go on and try another species or another technique.
Probably time to head off and see if we get a kahoi.
They are an eating fish, I'll just make sure that they're here. Yes, kahoi. I'm not sure what size you've got to beat, but I know that Jimmy did catch some, so better get amongst it because this weather's not going to hold.
With two more potential scoring fish for Team Barker, the heat is really now on Jimmy to make up some ground. So he's trying for a snapper on a soft bait to score a much needed point.
Time to score some points.
Score Sonia, Matty.
We're over till it's over.
Okie doke, Jimmy. We've got to get you that snapper. So, Trigger X soft bait, it's a paddle tail. Just give it a little wee flick out there. Let it float down. Be ready as it's sinking because they quite often pick it up. And then once it hits the bottom, flick, flick, wind.
Copy.
Okay, mate, all yours.
Sweet.
Bring it on, mate. Yeah, why not?
He's got him. Oh yeah, keep weight on him, mate. On the soft plastic,
nice.
Okay, so nice and smooth, keep your weight on him, mate. You beauty.
It'd be nice to just pull a snapper in right now.
Nice. Made him bigger than that, okay, well there you go. That's a nice panty, mate.
Nice.
And that's how this look out. Jeez, he's a real school. He's almost completely silver. And oh, foul hooked. I'm not sure that counts, mate. I'll check those rules.
Rules. Those rules you're talking about, any chance we can get a look at those?
I know you're going real good now, Jimmy, but we've just dropped below the lower wind limit, 5 knots. So, yeah, sorry. I think those last few fish might actually be disqualified.
Mate, isn't that a label, mate?
No, never mind. Never mind.
Damn it, not again.
Well, the ultimate cup officials are deciding if Jimmy's snapper qualifies. Dean is looking to put the result beyond doubt by catching a snapper on a soft bait longer than 43 centimetres and a kahawai longer than just 24 centimetres. We've come across kahawai feeding on the surface, and on my Furuno sounder, I've marked snapper hanging below.
Right there are the snapper marks.
Just give it a little wee tiny lob. Yeah, not too far yet, perfect.
There's two more potential points right here for Dean, but he's gonna have to be quick as we're approaching the upper wind limit for fishing in the Ultimate Cup. And if the wind reaches 23 knots, the day's fishing will be cancelled.
Yeah, Dave, I just sort of let it sink below the school. Oh yeah. Just nailed the soft bait under that shoal of fish. There we go.
Yes!
And look at that, our soft bait is ready to go again. The old Trigger X paddle tail, good to go. Right, I'll spike him. Oh, well, better get a measure. What have we got? 43, beautiful. It's like a production line now.
Beautiful.
The last act in the inshore fishing section of the Ultimate Cup is another nice snapper for Dean on a soft bait.
Here we go, that's a nice one. Well done, mate.
So with no more snapper fishing to be done, Dean comfortably takes the point for snapper on soft bait.
62.
Dean's snapper on a Lacanus was also good enough to take the win and earn a point for snapper on a lure. And with Jimmy failing to catch a gurnu, Dean takes another point. As with Trevelli, where Team Barker registered the only catch. But after five consecutive wins, Team Barker fails to catch a kahawai and has gifted Team Spittle a win, taking the score to Team Barker 5, Team Spittle minus 1. And now Jimmy has scored his first win. He's looking to stage his big comeback by heading out deep to target the big stuff.
Now, of course, the trick with any kind of fishing is you're not going to catch them if there's no fish there. And I've just located a shoal here. Now, 350 metres down, obviously you need a good sounder. There's a shoal here, which is all the blue marks, but there's some dark red targets in the middle. So if I just touch that shoal there, it's going to give me the option to put in a new point. I'm going to do that. Select that symbol there, and there it is. Bang, it's on the plotter. Now, that's what we've got to line up and drift over. And that way we'll be taking Jimmy's baits right through that shoal of fish. And if he's good enough, he'll catch one.
What's it go? We just sort of drift through here, do we?
The real trick with out doing what we're doing, it's sort of real deep water. And because we've got hundreds of metres to drop, it's to figure out which way the current's going, mark some fish, and then it's all a timing thing, being able to drop the baits down into them. And then, I mean, there's not a lot, heck of a lot of control you've got over what's going on 100 metres below you, but when you get one on, you've got to bring it back up.
Shazam.
Oh, what a day. The only thing at the top of this would be a fish. You know what I mean, like?
This would be a bonus.
Yeah, it'd be a real bonus. I mean, just keep it around here, mate. Just, this is where you want to focus. Just sort of this, the money shot right here. Don't stray too far from there. Okay? Nice and sort of in this box area. Just try and keep that in the lens. That'll do absolute wonders for your ratings. Yeah, I reckon anywhere around here, Matty?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you look pretty comfortable on that helm there.
No worries. Where is the button, though? Seriously.
It's all right, mate. I'll show you the button. All in good time, mate. Well, that's your sinker. That's 42 ounces of lead there. You've got a live bait and a nice big chunk of tuna.
Beautiful.
This guy here is a sturdy as harpooka rig. It's a Takeda 800, so you're free spool holding your weight with your thumb, and you're just letting that go down. A long way down. All yours.
Roger.
Okay, you just concentrate on that there and try and keep your eyes off this gear on the side of the boat. This is a bit of Team New Zealand technology over here.
Oh, what the?
Never mind, you're right over there, mate. Get as you were.
Mate, what's gentlemanly competition, mate? Mate, is that legal?
Boy, Jimmy, it doesn't look like your one. How come he hasn't got one of those?
Oh, because it's...
Mate, that thing's...
As technology, that thing, it's obviously technology you guys haven't developed yet, don't have access to. That's all right.
Jeez, I don't know. Late rule additions.
So while Jimmy's coming to terms with the rules, Dean is faced with much tougher conditions as he too targets a blue nose in the deep. But Team Barker are clearly ahead in the technology race, which could be a key part in deciding the winner of the Ultimate Cup.
Let it go down, let it go down. Let it go down. Now wind up. Wind.
Yep.
He's on. He's on now.
Got him. Rightio, time for the technology. Gotta love the technology.
It looks like this might be starting to angle out. Keep winding. It is a shark.
Blue nose.
It's a blue nose.
A blue nose.
It's a blue dog. It's only a little one, but it's a blue dog. Yay. Yeah. Maybe that school was blue nose. Well done, mate. Boom.
Nice.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes. Caught one of these
other
before?
Species? No, never.
They're stunning looking fish, aren't they? There you go.
You can just see, well, you can see where they get the name Blue Nose. That blue tinge on the nose, they've got that big eye, that amazing lens because they live in darkness. And you can just see how thick set they are. And at that size, would be a great swordfish bait. But no way, no. We gotta, let's not get distracted. Blue Nose is 62. Excellent.
Well done, mate.
Team Barker has registered a blue nose of 62 centimetres. So now Jimmy is attempting to catch a bigger one, but he'll have to haul it up out of 400 metres of water.
See how deep it is. I couldn't believe how deep it was. Getting a few bites, eh?
Made it?
Yeah. Come
here. know all about it when you get the big one on, mate.
Is that a bite you're getting there?
Dunno. Don't think so.
Just have a little wind. Just give it a little wind.
That looks like a bite, doesn't it?
Lift the rod tip up again.
Yeah, I think so.
Give it another wind. Yeah. You have to tighten up. If it's a bass, he'll go and try and get into a hole. Just get him moving, mate. Get him moving.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, boy?
Yeah, there he goes. He's under
now he's on.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, boy?
Yeah, there he goes. He's into
now
one.
He's on.
He's into one. Doesn't matter. It's not far to pull it in. That's a good one, boy. Look, it's taking some line. Get him moving away from the bottom. Get him moving. Use the rod to move him from the bottom. Because he will run you right into ground. You won't stand a show.
Get in there. Oh, look at him go. Jesus, the power of that boy. Another one for the good guys.
Live it up. Live it up.
So I'll say to you, Matty, just don't give up, mate, you know?
Just don't give up. Well, we've been here like 30 seconds. We've been here 30 seconds. I dropped you straight into a fish. Just don't start crowing at me just yet.
Started getting your head down a little bit. It's a good lesson for you. You just got to keep chipping away, mate. It's never over, you know what I mean?
Well, just 200 metres to go.
Mate, how's that electric thing going?
Just get back into it, son. I'll tell you what, it's all right when the grinder's doing all the work, eh?
Mate, what did I bring you?
You know, Jimmy, that under the rules you are allowed to actually use your grinder. I mean, it would be good to get him to do the donkey work and just take the rod off him at the end and get the glory.
Yeah, you know, I'm sort of just like a put in the hard yards, you know.
Mate, I reckon you're probably quarter of the way up.
Oh, hang on, I'd better have a look at the clock. There is a time limit. Oh, you've got about 30 seconds to get this fish in, mate, okay. Really. Yeah, I mean, you must know. I mean, that's fair enough. It's in the rules, isn't it? I mean, that would be normal for a sporting event, that when you're away and you've got it home and hosed, and then all of a sudden, time limit.
Never over, Matty. Never over. I thought it's over. Do your leg swap. The arms, eh, boy? That electric thing looks quite nice. It's hard yards, eh?
Is it?
Yeah. How are we looking on the time limit, Matty?
Just concentrate on the fish, we'll get to that, mate. I don't want to ruin the moment for you. We could call it a moral victory, you know? You know what it's like, you know, when really you did win, but you were robbed by some stupid rule.
How you getting on, mate?
Yeah, good, mate, just warming up.
Get a bit of burn in the arms?
Yeah, just the old rod on the old leg. It's a workout in the leg, just the bottom of the rod, eh? Am I doing something wrong? Is that where you put the bottom of the rod?
Where do I put the bottom of the rod? Yeah. Is it digging in a bit there?
Yeah, where do you put it?
I know, I put it in the gimbal belt, which is down there.
Oh, you don't get one of those.
Oh, did you want to?
No, good, mate.
I thought that was just the way you did it. Yeah, oh, sweet.
Old school, love it.
You seem to slow down, I don't know what it is.
Nah, just technique, ace. And go button. Hydro, please. Hydro. Come on, you guys.
Make sure that
update me on the time limit, mate.
Never
come on.
Mind the time limit. I don't want to ruin it.
It's a team, eh?
Look, I'm impartial.
Where are you meant to be helping?
No, I'm here impartial. I'm just here to assist.
It's got a late rule additions.
Well, this time around, the home team makes the rules, okay?
Mate, I love a challenge.
I know it's stupid. I know the rules are stupid, mate, but.
Nah, look, I love them.
What can I say? I didn't make them. Actually, I did.
You really look like you've lost some of your vim and vigour. You ever seen one of those liquid moustaches before, man?
Jeez. Really sort of starting to pay the penalty for letting all that line out.
It's starting to move out.
It's starting to angle out? Yeah, yep. Well, it could be one of our bass then if it's starting to angle up.
Yeah, it is. Angling away from the boat.
Yeah, Kane's seen it. He's off after it.
Here it comes. Got a colour down there.
Oh yeah, we've got some colour down there. Keep it steady, mate. You're doing a good job.
How's the time limit,
mate? Never mind the time limit. Just enjoy the catch. I think we both know that you've gone well over time. Oh, blue nose. A nice blue nose, too. Well done. Oh, beauty.
Hey.
Wow, look at the size of it.
And, mate, you won't find a better eating fish than that. Blue nose. Well done, mate. That's worth it. That's worthy of a pick or two. They're just so solid, aren't they?
On the board.
Well. We'll just check the we'll check the time.
Yeah, I think we just got in actually. Yeah.
Mate, you're in a bit of a lather.
No, I just caught a couple of rogue waves. It's pretty rough out here. I know, like, the cameras never show how rough it is. You know, we had the same issue in sailing, but it's actually really quite filthy out here, and I've been copping waves as I was pulling it in, so probably didn't see that.
Hang on to that, mate, and we'll get a pick.
Hey, big boy.
Wow, what a fish. That's the biggest fish I've ever caught in my life.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, well done. Well, we'll see if we can improve on that. We're going to have a good time then.
What a beauty.
I've got to say, I'm pretty keen to give that gimbal belt a run.
I mean, it is a lot of graft, you know, pulling fish out of the deep water, but the reward is a fish like that.
Man.
If you haven't tasted blue nose, well then...
So cool.
Yeah, you've got to get a piece of this.
Well, there you go, Dino. Another one for the scoreboard, mate. Just the slow comeback. Here it comes.
Nice, I love it.
With Jimmy now finding some form and starting his comeback, the Ultimate Cup is now set up for a grandstand finish. In next week's finale, Team Spithill are making their comeback and they continue to make up ground on Team Barker.
Mate, well done.
Awesome. Awesome.
Well done.
Awesome.
More points on the board.
Yeah.
Here we come.
There, drop a wine, get a wine, get a wine. I wanted to take this bloody banana back, it's not working.
But Dean rises to the challenge and lands some big fish. Come on, Dino, close it out. Make this one count. And with the competition balanced on a knife edge, the pressure of competing for the world's most prestigious maritime trophy begins to take its toll.
Oh, what have you done?
So tune in next week to find out who gets their hands on fishing's Ultimate Cup.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode, but if you're left wanting more, it's a good thing we've got more. Right now, you can log on anytime to ultimatefishing.tv or download the Ultimate Fishing app, because we're out here all the time, just like we are now. Fishing the depths, fishing the shallows, full episodes from all around the world, and fishing action and tips, and you can watch for free at ultimatefishing.tv.